This is the window you will see in Album Designer. We will show you how to design your spreads, and it's these fundamentals you will take through to auto design and adding additional spreads after using auto design. To start designing your spreads in planner view, you have your image well at the bottom, and it's here that you select the images you wish to use on the spread and then simply drag the images up onto the empty spread. If you like the layout that Fundy Album Designer has given you but want to rearrange the images within this layout, then click this icon here, which is the shuffle icon, and this will shuffle the images within the spread that Fundy Designer has given you. Alternatively, if you're not happy with the layout, you simply click this icon here and this will take you to the design picker, and as you can see, you have given much more options as far as how the album and the spread can look. To cycle through these, simply select this arrow here and you can see many different versions of the spread with the images that you have selected. Once you find one that you like, simply hit select. Once you have selected the layout you wish to use, you can also swap images around within this layout, simply by dragging the image across and place it where you would like it. Alternatively, if you decide that this image needs to be on its own individual spread, you can simply click and hold and drag to the new spread and make this a full page spread, leaving this page empty. So you can now go back into the design picker and then reselect and adjust the spread to suit your taste. To add an image and a spread between these two spreads, simply drag the image in question between the gap of the two spreads and enter the new spread. You can also maneuver these spreads around by clicking this icon and drag in the spread where you'd like it to be in the album. For even more designer control, you can design in the view option. You can do this by either clicking view or simply double clicking on any spread, and this will open the spread to fill the page. As you can see, we have the guides on here. To turn these off, simply hit the G key to turn them off. I like to keep these guides on so I can see my trim line and also my safe area to design in. Once you are in the design view, you can control your images a lot better and you can see exactly the finer tweaks you might want to make. For example, clicking the spanner option here means that we can now zoom the image in as well as rotate and change the opacity. Once you are happy with the layout of this spread, to move to the next spread in this view, simply click the arrow icon here. Now this is one of only three spreads. So to add a new spread from here, click Add New Spread. Again, to design your spread, select the images in which you wish to use and simply drag them up into the spread. As you can see, we might want to make a few changes here, so it's just as simple as dragging the image across. And again, to enter the design picker from this view, click the layout option at the top, and this will take you to the design picker. And from here, select the one that you would like to use and adjust, and then that's your spread. If I would like to add one more image to this spread, I need to just select the image in question and drag it up to the right hand side, and it will be placed here. As you can see, it looks a little bit squished, so what we can do is we can try and use the individual drop zones to bring this out and level it up with the top here. The drop zones work in a way that we can adjust everything to make it perfect and just how we'd like it to be in the album. To change the auto design preference on these four images here, from rows to vertical columns, you can see this icon here. This stipulates that currently it is organizing in rows. To change it to columns, click and you can see the orientation of the images will change. So this image, for example, as you can see, is a landscape image. So we want this ideally as a landscape. So by clicking it now into columns again, you can see we have now given more preference to the original orientation of this image. Once again, to confirm, when the icon is horizontal, then Fundy Drop Zone will design the images with a horizontal orientation. To click to the vertical, it will now orient in vertical columns. You can also see that when I select the drop zone, it is surrounded by an orange box. That means that any of the options here will affect anything in this drop zone. For example, turning the images to black and white. If I would like to individually edit an image within this drop zone, then I simply select the image and then choose from the options at the bottom and turn this one, for example, back into color. To adjust just the single column or row, you can select and hover over the orientation and you will get a prompt to see that if I hold the shift key down, I can change the original orientation in just this row here. Meaning that this image is left entirely alone. To make this drop zone perfect, we need horizontal rows. So we just change it from here. As you can see, we have a little bit of play within this image. Using this icon here, you can change for the images to fill the drop zone or to fit with the ratio that you have selected. So we just change it from there. To change the ratio from 3x2 to original square, 1:1, the original ratio as it, the point of capture, as well as a horizontal preference and a vertical preference. Of course, each photographer has their own ideas on how they would like their sprays to look, so we will leave the final design down to you. Whether you are in the designer view or planner view, you can design your album using hotkeys. So when I click on the layouts button, either by clicking on this icon here and going to the design picker, you will notice there are 12 options, and these 12 options correlate to the numbers key and the plus and minus key on the top of your keyboard. So for example, if I select this spread and cycle through 1 through 12 on the keyboard, 11 being the minus, 12 being the plus, we can see that each of the designs in the design picker are available to us. If, for example, we like spread number 7, but prefer the main image on the right-hand side, we hit the spacebar key and this will flip the spread. And then once you are happy with the spread layout, you can adjust to taste. You can add and maneuver your spreads in the design view really easily by simply selecting the top icon here and then place the spread in the desired location. If you wish to add a spread between these spreads, you can simply select the images and then drag until you see a yellow box between the two spreads. If you don't see the yellow box, then you need to update your version of Fundy Designer. Once you're happy with the placement, let go of the mouse and the spread will appear between the two spreads. And once you've dropped this new spread in, you can change the design as you would in any other Fundy spread, simply by clicking this option here to enter the design picker or using the hotkeys to change the spreads around. If you are in the designer view and you would like to add a new spread after the current spread you are viewing, then simply click the add spread option at the top right here and then scroll through and then select the images you wish and they will populate using the designer. And this concludes the overview on how you design single spreads using Fundy Designer.